Hi everybody, this is Nick, and in this video we're just going to continue on analyzing our zip code lists with this pivot table, and I have three questions here that we want to answer. Really quickly, what percent of visitors come from out of state, what percent of visitors come from in-state, and what percent are from outside the United States? And this is from an organization that was from the state of Colorado. So anything within the state of Colorado will be in-state, and anything else will be out of state. So two of these questions we can answer really easily with our pivot table that we created in the previous video of all of our zip codes and our states. The first thing though that I want to do is I want to get rid of this missing. I'm not going to include the missing data that we have. So that may increase some of our percentages of our data. So I want to go ahead and just exclude that from the list. And to do that, all I need to do is click on that drop-down menu, go down to find where missing is right here at the bottom and unselect it. And when we unselect that, it removes itself from our pivot table. And now we are no longer using those missing values in the calculations for our data table. So let's just go here for what percent are from in-state. It looks like 84% is from Colorado. So that's perfect. So we already know that. So if anyone asks you what percent of your visitors are from in-state here, or maybe locals, we can say that's 84% of our visitors. Same thing, 4% of visitors are from outside the United States. International right here, we have, there's 7 people that said they were from outside the United States. That's 0.7%. So let's just say 0.7%. Maybe I'll just round up to 1%. So we know those two things just from this big table, but now we want to know what percent of visitors are from out of state. And you can see that we have a lot of visitors from many, many different states. Oh, you know, several states we have represented in our data. And I could go through here and make some manual calculations, but I can also do it really quickly in the pivot table by grouping values inside the pivot table. And to do that, all I need to do is hold down the, what we're going to do is we're going to hold down the mouse key and just drag and click on this. When you right click here, we could go to group, but it's just going to group the things that I have highlighted here. If we want to group multiple things and we have other values in between, just hold down the control key and then it will highlight everything else. So you can highlight multiple non-connecting ranges of cells by just holding down that control key and then with your mouse go into that range and highlighting it. Now right click these cells. We're going to click on group, and it's going to go ahead and it grouped everything here for us, and it's in the accordion, so you can still see the individual state data, but we're going to go ahead and just type this inside here. We could type out of state, so we can name the group what we want, and it looks like 149 cases were from out of state. That's 15.3%, and so now I know that 15% of my audience is from out of state, 84% is from in-state, and 1% is from outside the United States. This was a great tip to analyze those zip code lists that you have if you are from places like museums, zoos, aquariums, or have any other audience. If you want to download our zip code lookup template, I'm going to put that in the description below. Go ahead and check that out. And otherwise, I hope you all have a wonderful day. I had a great time making this for you. Make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. Have a great day. I can't wait to see you all next time.